it takes just a few seconds to get it going, to get this thing going.
So the lag time for aerobic, the aerobic system is a few seconds?
It's a lag time. So the PC system, it is there for intense, very short duration things. Okay, we're good to go on that. It is also what you would call an immediate system. So that's the add-on for today. The PC system is also an immediate system. So when I first start out, boom, and these guys, these quads and all this, they're contracting. Where does the energy come from? Well, it comes from breaking the P's. And it comes from the PC system. Now, if after a few seconds of the PC system, then I'm going to transition into the aerobic system.
So the PC system is always the very first thing to start.
Always the very first thing that you're going to see.
What about the lactic acid? How much lag time does it have?
Just a very short period. I've never seen it written down, so I'm going to say a few seconds.
Would just like lifting your arm above your head, would that be the PC system?
What system?
Or is it, I mean, I would think it'd be the PC system.
It'd be
the
PC system, definitely.
So just any small movement, quick movement like that is also the PC system?
Yes. Okay, now when I get my story out in a minute, you're going to see all kinds of this person doing all kinds of different things. I want you to look at what the person's doing and see if you can nail the system is doing whatever throughout the story. Immediate and really intense. Okay, that goes to the PC. Got that? All right, here we are. You have run as hard as you can until you cannot run anymore, and you're over on the side of the road or track or whatever, and you are sucking air. Has anybody sucked air, as they say?
Mm-hmm.
And you sound like this.
Mm-hmm.
Anybody
mm-hmm.
identify with that part? All right.
Literally me.
And let's fast forward. I'm okay.
Yeah, I do that.
Do I not suck in air? All right, now, when you decide to quit, what's the state of your lactic acid and what's the state of your PC?
When we decide to quit or when
yeah.
our body quits?
All right, so you have started to sprint around the track. How far can you go?
Not very far.
I'll pick something then.
100 meters.
Okay. All right, Kira can go 100 meters. Congratulations.
Maybe better than me.
50.
Okay, at the end of 100 meters. All right. Talk to me about lactic acid.
Well, lactic
all
acid
cells.
Has built up.
Okay. Well, can it shut your cell down?
Yes.
Yeah. Uh-huh.
Because of the acidity?
Mm-hmm.
What about your PC?
PC's
not
used up at this point.
Have you busted everything in the PC up?
Yeah.
When did you bust it up?
At the beginning.
At the beginning? When you crossed over into second number 11,
mm-hmm.
PC system's gone?
So does all of the PC get used?
Yes.
Then the lactic acid system gets used?
Okay.
Or
the question, how quickly will the lactic acid system kick in? Now, the intensity of the activity is going to determine how much PC had to be used in that first part.
Okay.
What if it is you started out, I mean, as hard as you could go. You probably busted up all of the PC. What if you started out not quite as hard, but fairly hard? You might not use all the PC before you got to the lactic acid, because it's, remember, a little lag time.
So as soon as the lactic acid starts, then PC stops?
Yes.
Okay.
Now, the question is, look back at your PC. Did you bust all the PC up?
Not
to that point? Not necessarily. Now, what if it was more intense?
You might have busted
it. Would you pretty much wasted the PC system? Mm-hmm. And you would have. All right, you're sucking air. Let's say the PCs are completely busted and you are full of lactic acid. So what you need to do, you need to do what is recovery. So here's the last stop, recovery. So recovery has two parts. Well, recovery has, there's a lactate and an alactate portion to something called oxygen debt. And this is all part of recovery. Recovery being you're sitting there sucking air. So my description is sucking air. The book's description would be oxygen debt. So this is the book's fancy way of saying sucking air. The amount of oxygen consumed during recovery above what you would have breathed anyway. Okay, you're going to stand there and breathe a certain amount of oxygen. Beyond that, that's going to be your oxygen debt. Not putting any numbers on it. The extra oxygen is going to be used to take care of the extra lactic acid you have. So I want to get rid of the lactic acid, and I want to put all the P's and C's back together. I want to restore everything the way it was. The way it used to be. All right, now you tell me where all the lactic acid is. I am standing there with my hands on my knees, sucking. Talk to me about the lactic acid down here in these quads.
It's in your muscle cells and in your blood.
Okay, she says I can find a lot of lactic acid in the cell itself.
The cells and the blood.
And how did it get out of blood?
Concentration gradient. It went from low to high level.
Okay. And why did it shut the cell down?
Because it couldn't go high level.
Maybe it's the acidity, right?
The pH difference.
pH difference. Okay. So normally, your cell has a pH. This is Trivial Pursuit. 7.3. So 7.4. Give me a new number. 6 point something, 6.7, 6 point, it doesn't make any difference, but it's definitely more acidic. That shuts your cell down, boom, I'm done. I had to stop. But now I'm trying to get rid of all the lactic acid. And we're trying to put the P's and C's back together. All right, you're sucking air, what system are you in? You're standing there sucking air. Now you have three.
Aerobic.
You're in the aerobic system.
Okay, so.
All right, now. This is a do your thing. The do your thing is whatever your body decides it wants to do, whatever it needs to do. It needs to put the P's and C's back together, it needs to get rid of the lactic acid. Where is the energy going to come from to do all that?
ATP.
Okay, where does the energy always come from?
ATP.
From putting the P from the ATP? Mm-hmm. Okay. Who can generate the ATPs? Which system can generate the ATPs in order to do that? Remember, you only have a limited amount of ATP. So which system is now up there trying to put the P's back on so you can use them to get rid of the lactic acid and get rid and put the PCs back together?
Aerobic.
It's got to be the aerobic system. So you are operating aerobically right here. Busting up this glucose, going all the way through. Okay, for every glucose, how many P's do you end up netting? 30. And what do you turn right around and do with those guys?
Use them.
And you're breaking those P's in order to, as I'm sitting here doing this,
get the Restore the pH in the cell.
And?
Lactic acid, get rid of it.
Get rid of all the, get all the lactic acid, change it to something that's more friendly. But that's gonna take some energy. All energy comes from breaking those P-bonds off of the ATP. How to do it. Okay, so the extra oxygen beyond what you would have breathed anyway. Okay, that's what oxygen, that is being used to generate P's from the aerobic system. Now, how long is it going to take you to do that?
What does your body turn the lactic acid into?
There's a variety of things it can be turned into. It can be turned back into glucose. It can be turned into carbon dioxide and water. It can be turned. There's a lot of things.
The body.
The takeaway is it's not lactic acid anymore.
Can the body take the lactic acid and send it through the aerobic system, or?
It can change it.
Can it change it into
to something else? It can change it back to pyruvic acid. If you can count the pyruvic acid, then when you get to pyruvic acid, then you can go more down into the aerobic thing after that. All right, so when you pick up a book, oxygen debt is defined as a lactate portion and an alactate. The lactate is the lactic acid, the alactate is the PC. So get the lactic acid changed, get the PC put back together, and now I'm ready to go again. Everything has been put back together and you're ready to start over. Okay, time out right there. Go.
I think I just missed what you said. The lactate is PC?
The lactic acid is building up.
It's
leaking out of the cell. It's getting into blood, as Kara said. But eventually it's going to build up so much in the cell, it's going to shut your cell down because the pH is dropping. So now I've got to deal with all that lactic acid that accumulated. That's the
it's a step. So lactate,
yes,
is a step where lactic acid is converted
into
something else.
Various things. Okay, the alactate. A not lactate. Mm-hmm. So they assume you know.
So it's the PC.
It's going to be the PC system. So all those P's and C's that are floating around separately, let's get them back together again.
So it's just the PC being put back together?
Yes, that's it. Why did I just say it that way? Yeah, I don't know why.
It's going to make things complicated.
Because it's going to make it all complicated. Do you have a limited amount of PC?
Yeah.
Mm-hmm. Got to keep.
So does part one have to happen before part two?
Courtesy of which system? Courtesy of the aerobic system, where I'm generating 36 every time the glucose goes through the whole thing. Then I'm breaking those 36 up to take care of my two systems, get them all back together, boom, and I'm a happy camper.
So you said alactate part is just the PC's part?
That's it. Okay. Yep. Okay. If some of you will take a class like this, you can major, and some people exercise physiology. That's a very common major. A lot of people go to WVU, and they are, that is their major. So you start talking about a lot of these kind of things, and that's just, it would be very common to hear people talk about all this stuff in exercise physiology, because you're exercising.
Mm-hmm.
Okay. All right, look at this one. Okay, here's one of those fancy terms somebody's figured out. And I wouldn't have said it that way. They don't care the way I say it. So once you get it down, just call time out.
And it's at that 85% max.
Just hang this, leave that out there for a second. Can I say fatigue? Did lactic acid get me? It's building up so much. And when you reach lactic threshold or lactic acid threshold, then you've got more lactic acid than your cell can deal with, and you have fatigued. All right, does everybody have the same threshold?
No.
Does everybody fatigue at the same place?
No.
At the same time? What if you could delay fatigue? Happy face or frowny face?
Happy face.
Happy face. What would that mean?
More
what would it mean as far as your race goes?
You can run for longer.
Mm-hmm.
Would you agree with her?
Yep.
Okay, how can I increase my lactic threshold?
Training.
There's three things that you're going to do by training. Anybody remember?
You lessen the amount you produce. You get rid of it more quickly. And
three?
And tolerate more, right?
And tolerate more. Everybody have one?
Yes.
Do even world-class sprinters have a lactic threshold?
Eventually.
Wasn't there this one guy, we watched this video this one time called superhumans or something like that.
Yeah.
And there was this one guy who he could keep, and he was a marathon runner, so I think it may have been a little bit different than the lactic acid, but he could keep going. Like, he just didn't fatigue. Normally, and he just could run 4 miles and miles and pop miles and not
scared. We are wow. Okay, moving on to this last one right here.
Oh,
I'm sorry.
Yeah,
I'm behind.
Me too.
What is that
85%
ability to get rid of lactic acid produce production? What's the third thing? What's the third
thing? This is somebody's way to sort of go, do you want to try to figure out where your lactic threshold is? So they did something, they gave us something that you could do at home. You can try this at home. So they said take 85% of your maximum heart rate. Maximum heart rate is defined as, you can take heart rate, you can go carotid or radial pulse, 220 minus your age. Okay, there's a little formula. I'm not sure it's perfect. 220 minus 18 for you guys?
Mm-hmm. I'm 16.
So 202 is?
203.
203, whatever that is. Take 85% of that. So go out and let's start to run. You got a heart rate monitor or something on? Your Fitbit?
Yeah.
Or not? Something that can monitor your heart rate. Anybody wear a monitor? She's got one. She can look down and tell you what her heart rate is right away. I don't know. Some people wear it when they exercise so they can check where their heart rate is. Okay, as your intensity goes up, as your heart rate goes up, will your lactic acid go up?
Yes.
probably so. So when they say when you get to 85%, you're going pretty hard then. That at 85%, that might be, I'm not sure I'm going to bet a lot of money on this, that might be where your lactic acid threshold is. So that means 85% of, say, 200 would be 170 for you guys. I think that's wimpy. I think it needs to go higher. That's my. I think you could get it to 170, and I think you could maintain 170 for a while. I don't think that would be a real challenge to you. I don't think the lactic acid would get you.
I think so too, because I was like running once, and I know it was at least 165, and I was fine for a long time. Wasn't fun.
I think we need to jack that up a little bit.
Yeah.
And go probably.
I don't get your units. Like 85% of your heart rate equals the lactate threshold, but like what unit is that?
So beats per minute. Is lactate threshold defined in terms of heart rate?
No, it is not.
So.
That's just something that I'm trying to throw in because you go, well, I want to know where mine is.
So it's when you get to a heart rate of 170 that you would reach your lactate threshold,
sort of give you a ball,
whatever that may be.
Yes.
But could you, like, even if you reach your lactate threshold, couldn't you still continue?
Until? Like,
to run?
Until your cell shuts down.
Until your cell shuts down, yes.
Okay.
Here's a more. If you have a higher lactate threshold, can you delay fatigue?
Yes.
Okay. That's my takeaway. Okay, the person you're talking about, they can run forever.
Yeah.
Okay. Come over here. Okay. Here's another exercise physiology, and this is it right here. Called VO2 max. I write it volume of oxygen. You'll also see it written like this. And this is an aerobic kind of a moment right here. Everybody has a limit. Everybody has a max for the amount of oxygen they can move. So this person you're talking about.
Yeah. He must have a really,
really high VO2 max. If you could move more oxygen in, and you can say, over here, you can say, hey, what do you say right here? When you get to pyruvic acid, what's a decision your cell has to make?
If there's oxygen
or not. Okay, if you can keep saying yes, advantage?
Yes.
Why?
It's more aerobic system, it's more efficient, so you can generate more energy.
What if you say, all of a sudden you say no?
You switch to the lactic acid system.
Switch to the lactic acid system, and now lactic acid begins to accumulate, and your fatigue is not that far away, because you're going to reach your lactic threshold, and you're going to shut it down. This stuff kind of interests you. If you go, well, I wonder what mine is. That guy you're talking about. It is really, really way up there. When you start Googling this, they start talking about some of these kind of people you're talking about.
Yeah.
And like they're just like off the charts. Good. But then they get back to the rest of us, and they go, well, the average and that they do it in age groups. And they go, if you're in this age group, here's what's really excellent, here's what's pretty good, here's what sucks. You know, and then you can go all the way from really good to really, really bad. But they give you some formulas that you can plug numbers into to try to determine your VO2 max. Back in the day at Marshall, I was in an exercise physiology class, and we did this. We had to put a big mask on, we got on a treadmill, we were chugging on the treadmill, and they were timing us, and you know, and we plugged all those numbers in, and we came up with a VO2 max. Anyway, I thought it was pretty cool, except not the running part. I didn't think that was cool. You had to go as hard as you could go. It was interesting. So we got our VO2 maxes, and then we looked at your chart, and some people's ego was crushed.
No, that would be me.
Can you improve your VO2 max?
Yes.
Train.
So how would you have to train?
Aerobically?
You have to train the aerobic system in order to improve your VO2 max.
So
anyway, lactate, whichever one, threshold, VO2 max, very much a part of exercise, physiology, and that kind of thing. Okay, comments before I do the story?
One quick thing.
Go.
Does the VO2 max have more to do with how your cells handle the oxygen
Yes.
or how much oxygen you bring in?
But all of the above.
All of the above?
What does it say when it says... You go.
Okay.
Really quick. So theoretically, if you say played a brass instrument and you had to train your lungs a lot,
oh yeah,
would you have a higher VO2 max even if you didn't ever exercise ever in your entire life?
Yes.
Yeah.
And you do.
Absolutely. Nailed that one. Yeah.
I don't need to.
You don't need no stinking running.
I take one breath per year. That's it.
Hey Doc. What does the MN stand for when it says
muscle? Because I'm lazy.
Oh, okay. I was
so
like, I didn't know if it was like muscle cell or like...
To the muscle.
All right,
how about this? What if, because we can't see inside, so what if one person has, their lungs are larger
than your VO2.
Than somebody else's.
They'll have a higher VO2.
Okay.
So that's like...
There's lots of your...
That's what it is.
Okay, here we go. You can solo this thing, or you can
like
team it up. I've got a baseball.
You're like highly dissing this batter.
Or here.
The batter.
Now, I apologize to anybody who hates baseball or tries not to even watch baseball or doesn't even know who the batter is. Because I've had people, sometimes I use examples and people go, what do you mean there? I don't know about the bat, what's the batter's box? And if you haven't done it, then you're clueless. So
especially
I don't know how much explanation you need,
box.
But this person's going to stand in the batter's box and swing
right
the bat
now
and hit a ball,
baseball.
And they're going to chase it and he's going to run. And
yeah, we should learn by doing it.
We're going to park a lot and play baseball.